by now, you've seen a shitload of my riding videos, most likely, if you're dialed in on YouTube. So I'm just going to do a quick buzz around here, not to belabor the point on this. So I realized after having this bike almost 9 months, I never gave it a proper review yet. So figured I'd fuck around and point out a few things about the bike that I like, which is a lot. And in the meantime, get some info out there about what to expect when you buy this bike. Changes to the bike since I got it. Mostly just cosmetic stuff. I don't want to burn out the battery or controller or ruin any of the mechanics of this bike. Try to get to a nice quiet spot where I can show you all the details of the bike. This is the 1100 model, the first round of bikes. They're a little different now. this came to me as class 3. It will hit 33 miles an hour. I've gotten it to 34 going downhill and pedaling a little bit. It weighs about 72 pounds with the battery in. I like black and yellow together, so I really went all in. And my seat is going to be custom too. There's going to be a yellow diamond stitching. So here's everything I changed. First, the grips. I got the old grips off and put on these locking grips. Easy on-off locking grips. I added front pegs. This is Odyssey brand in the front. They have an anti-spin pin that goes into the dropout, which is nice. I changed up the pedals, chain ring, and the chain. That's an Origin 8 chain ring and a KMC, I believe, chain. And then I put pegs on the back. These are Black Ops. These also have the anti-spin pin, but with this model, the 1100, this is the first gen model, the pin didn't quite fit into the dropout with all the washers and nuts on it. So what I did was I took the anti-spin pin off and then just connected it that way. A lot of people are asking about the pegs, what pegs to use. As I said, this Black Ops one worked because it had a wide enough tube to get the deep socket and 21 millimeter socket wrench down in there. For example, the Odyssey brand in the front does not fit the 21 millimeter socket. So for your rear, you're going to want to use either the Black Ops or the SE Bikes brand. And then also, I've got yellow Duro tires on. I just wanted to make a scene when I'm riding around. People know who it is. One thing I will recommend with the tires, I would strongly suggest, at least for the back wheel, putting in a tire liner. What I did was I got corn-resistant tubes, I got a tire liner, and then I put slime brand stuff that fix a flat on the fly into the tube as well. So it's kind of a triple threat. I could probably take a knife to this and not have a flat. But especially do so on the back wheel because there's more weight back there. You're sitting on this end, you got more weight pressing down. This is a heavier wheel to begin with because of the hub. So it's good to have a little extra protection in there. And I also threw on this this fender. You can ride this bike in the rain. There is a little protector shield under there over the controller, but this will give you a little more security if you're really out there in the rain. I don't really ride in the rain too much anymore, but you can. Just, you know, be cautious about it. The rear fender is called Big Buck, and it's by Planet Bike. I think it was about 30 bucks. It's a nice locking strap mechanism here to keep it in place. It's probably the most sturdy of all the ones I tried. I had a cheapo one on here and it sucked, so I got rid of it. Yellow caps, like I said, all cosmetic. And then we'll get to the straps in a second. These are mostly cosmetic as well, just for the look. Did a little bit of detailing with some nail polish. These straps go around this bar down and under and up the other side. And then they loop down and around the bar on that side too, and then they Velcro up underneath. Now, this is totally not needed. If you put your battery in correctly, it's not going anywhere unless you really get slammed. And the way you know that it's in correctly is if it slides on nice, and when you turn this key, there is zero resistance when you spin it to lock. If you feel anything catching, or if you feel the key with a little resistance when you go to turn it, it's in wrong. Something might be in the way. Maybe you've got something back here, or maybe there's some zip ties from underneath that hold the cables against the bar. Maybe they're in the way and they're lodged against the locking mechanism. So just check it, make sure it's nice and sturdy, spin the key, no resistance, and then bang on it. It's not going anywhere. I saw some comments on the Facebook owners group where people's batteries were flying out. So before I got my bike, I was paranoid. I was like, oh, of course that's gonna happen to me because I suck and I'm gonna do something wrong. So I got straps. I went through a bunch of different types and they're all fine. I ended up with these ones because they look cool and they match. But you don't need them. You really don't need them. And at this point, for me, it's just another accent to the yellow and black look of my bike. And this strap here, I just keep on because I tried to do a wheelie and I wiped and I scuffed my seat. That's why I'm getting a nice new cover. But I keep this here to cover the seat scuff and in case I need a strap to hold anything down while I'm riding. So why do I love this bike? It's fast, it's nimble, gets me to and from work with ease, cuts my commute in half, takes me back to the old days of 80s BMX. Got an awesome design, great build, sexy as hell, makes all the heads turn. This bike is awesome.